Programs are normally written as a collection of source files assembled in the object files, then linked together. But there is another way to combine the files. For some things, you want to combine the source files. An obvious use for this is so you can organize macros. You can put all your macro definitions in a single source file and then have that file included as if it were a part of every assembly language file you have. Not only does this mean that you only have to write your macros once, it also means that if you correct a macro, it is corrected for all your source files. This is done just like it's done in C with the include preprocessor directive and the name of the file in quotes. The search for the file is made first by the assembler looking in the current directory and then in any directories that you may have specified on the command line by using the I option. One of the inconveniences of including files this way is the undesirable result of including the same file more than once. That can be prevented inside the include file. At the top of every file that you're going to include, you can put two lines that look like this. If the one-line macro is already defined, nothing happens. However, if the one-line macro is not defined, then it becomes defined and the entire file is assembled. Of course, at the end of the file, you'll need to include an endif to match the leading if. Another way to include source files is to use the P option on the command line. This way, the file is included even though there is not an include directive in the source code. Whether this is a good idea or not depends on how well you document your system. You can use the path search directive to get the path name of a file in your program. This example defines macp as being the path name of the file. Now, the search for the file is done the same way that it was done previously. For example, if you use the I directive on the command line to specify a search directory, and the file macros.mac is found in that directory, the resulting path name assigned to macp will be the file name along with its directory name, and that's the value assigned to the one-line macro macp. There are standard macro packages defined as part of the assembler. Instead of include, you use the use directive and specify the name of the macro package. There is more about these packages in a later lesson. The directive works the same as the include directive, except the quotes around the name are not required. There is a problem, though. If the name of the macro package also happens to be the name of a locally defined macro, without the quotes, the name will be expanded. It's best to use the quotes and make sure you get what you are after. The standard macro packages are all protected from multiple inclusion, so there is never a problem including files that also use the standard macros. Whenever you use standard macros, whichever one you use defines a one-line macro that you can test to determine what code to generate. All these macros are in the form shown here, the word use followed by the system macro name, all in uppercase with underscores,